In the last weeks of 2019, while the world was ready to welcome the year 2020, many local hospitals in Wuhan, China reported an unusual number of cases who had severe pneumonia without a clear cause, and they were not responding to any form of existing vaccine or medicines. Soon after, a seafood market in the Hunan region was linked to all these cases. This was a wholesale seafood market which had about 1,000 stalls selling fish, chickens, bats, snakes, rabbits, and many other wild animals. These cases showed a very high human-to-human transmission rate, which was further increasing as the days progressed. An initial hypothesis was formulated that this was a new type of coronavirus that evolved in the animals being sold in the seafood market of Wuhan. This resulted in a fear that it could be similar to the SARS epidemic of 2002, which infected 8,000 people and killed 774. But they were all wrong, because this was going to be something much worse. By early January 2020, about 59 suspected cases were picked up from all local hospitals in Wuhan and isolated in the Jingyintan Hospital of Wuhan. Out of these 59 suspected cases, 41 were confirmed with the 2019 novel coronavirus infection. Their isolation was too late, and before they were isolated, these cases had infected hundreds of others that eventually infected thousands, and thus starting the 2019 novel coronavirus epidemic. What started as a localized epidemic in the central China quickly spread to involve all other Chinese provinces in a matter of few weeks. This spread was escalated by the Chinese New Year and thousands of tourists out of their home. The situation became very tense when cases in other countries were also reported, which were transmitted by international travelers. The first cases were reported from Vietnam, and soon after, several new cases were reported from Germany, Thailand, Japan, Australia, United States, Russia, and a dozen of new countries, leading to a global panic situation. The epidemic costed its first death on January 9, 2020, but the death toll had just begun. As of making this video, the novel coronavirus epidemic has led to more than 95,000 confirmed cases, of which 8,000 are serious. More than 65 countries have been affected with major outbreaks in central China, South Korea, Italy, and Iran. More than 3,300 people have died due to this epidemic. You can imagine the gravity of the situation by looking at these facts. The WHO declared the epidemic as a global health emergency as of 30 January 2020. Delta Airlines, United Airlines, and American Airlines all have completely suspended their flights to China, while several other airline companies have severely reduced their number of daily flights. The US government has temporarily banned entry into the United States by any foreign national who has traveled to China in the past 14 days. China has placed its numerous cities in government lockdown that in effect has quarantined millions of people. The Chinese stock market is constantly crashing, and this has led to a global economic slowdown already. See, the word coronavirus is derived from the Latin word corona, meaning crown or halo, which refers to the characteristic appearance of this virus. The virus consists of a core of genetic material surrounded with an envelope of protein spikes. This gives it an appearance of a crown, and crown in Latin means corona, hence the name coronavirus. Coronaviruses are a group of viruses that cause disease in mammals and birds. These are RNA viruses with a genome of 26 to 32 kilobases. New coronaviruses have been detected every few years, with the first ones being discovered in the 1960s, which caused mild respiratory infections in chickens. Since then, a number of different coronaviruses have been discovered, mostly affecting birds, bats, and other small, warm-blooded animals. These viruses often get mutated in the animals they circulate, and due to the close contact of humans with these animals, these viruses can jump from the animal to the human to start a new disease. Many coronaviruses have already infected humans, including the SARS coronavirus, which led to the SARS epidemic in 2003, the MERS coronavirus, and the human coronavirus NL63. The latest addition to these names is the novel coronavirus, informally known as the Wuhan coronavirus. New viruses are detected all the time. It's known that coronavirus species circulate in a variety of animals. Sometimes these viruses can make a jump from animals to humans. This is known as a spillover and can be due to a number of reasons, like mutations in the virus itself or increased close contact between humans and animals, like we discussed. For example, MERS coronavirus is known to be transmitted from camels to humans and SARS coronavirus from civet cats. The animal reservoir of 2019 novel coronavirus is not clear yet. Many of the early coronavirus cases were linked to the South China seafood wholesale market in Wuhan, but the earliest documented case, which has been traced back to 1st December, had no connection to the market, surprisingly. How this virus spreads from one person to another is not completely understood yet. But we know that the most common way it has been spreading is through droplet infection. It is when a person who is infected coughs or sneezes and releases viral particles that remain suspended in the air and are picked up by another person. It is also transmitted through things that an infected person has been closely in contact with, like used towels, clothes, switches, keys, and door handles. Those who are at the highest risk are people who are in close contact with animals, like animal market workers, and those who are taking care of infected, like family members, doctors, or nurses. The WHO has coined the term 2019 novel coronavirus acute respiratory disease to describe the disease caused by this virus, indicating that most of the symptoms of the disease are related to the respiratory system. Now, from what we know is that there can be a number of symptoms ranging from mild to severe. The mild cases can present with fever, cough, shortness of breath, and the severe ones can lead to pneumonia, kidney failure, and death. The most widely used test to detect the coronavirus infection is the PCR, or the polymerase chain reaction. This test detects the minute quantities of genetic material of the virus and amplifies it so it can be studied easily. You can watch the video about PCR on our channel to know more about this. Links in the description bar down below. There is currently no vaccine to prevent the 2019 novel coronavirus infection. The best way to prevent infection is to avoid being exposed to this virus. However, CDC always recommends everyday preventive actions to help prevent the spread of respiratory viruses, which includes steps like washing your hands with soap and water for at least 20 seconds, covering your mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing, using an alcohol-based sanitizer that contains 60% alcohol or more, and avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with unwashed hands. Stay home when you are sick and avoid close contact with people who are sick. Clean and disinfect frequently touched objects and surfaces. The work to develop the vaccine for coronavirus is already underway. Scientists believe that research of MERS vaccine, which was also a coronavirus, will make this job easier. And hospitals are testing antiviral drugs to see if they have an impact. While the ratio of deaths to known cases appears low, the figures are unreliable. It is far too simplistic to divide the number of deaths by the number of cases to calculate the death rate, to get a figure of around 2% at this stage of the outbreak. But it depends upon a range of factors like your age, sex, general health, and health system you are in. Thousands of patients are still being treated, and we do not know if any of those cases will die, so the death rate could be higher. It is because of the size and density of the population and close contact with animals harboring viruses. The short answer to this question is absolutely yes. Many of those who contract coronavirus will experience only mild symptoms. These include fever, coughing, and respiratory problems. Most people are expected to make a full recovery, but can pose a particular risk for elderly people and those with pre-existing problems like diabetes or cancer. So I hope I am able to share some knowledge about the 2019 novel coronavirus pandemic with you through this short video. If you like the video, make sure to hit the like button below. You can also help us make more videos like this by supporting our channel on patreon.com or joining our YouTube channel by clicking the join button below. I'll be highly thankful.